Hi, ma'am. Thank you so much for joining us. We'll be with you in just a bit. Right after that, could I please invite Sudha Kumbhara, the director of Ilame Edo Edo, to join us. And alongside her, of course, the star cast, Kalidas Jayaram. Thank you so much, Kalidas. Thank you so much, Sudha. All right, up next, could I please welcome Gautam Vasudev Menon, the director of Avalam Nanu. Avaram Nanu. Thank you so much, Gautam, for joining us. And with you, of course, I'd like to invite MS Bhaskar, sir, and Ritu Verma. Thank you so much for joining us once again. Right after, could I please invite Rajiv Menon, the director of Free Union. Hi, Rajiv. Thank you so much for joining us. And right after, could I please invite Karthik Subbaraj, the director of Miracle, along with its actor, Bobby Sinha. Well, thank you very much. This is giving me goosebumps, this very screen right now. Welcome all of you. I must say it's an honor to be present amidst five creative visionaries and the super talented cast. I'm delighted to get a chance to speak to each and every one of you. Each film, of course, seems to have a unique storyline, characterization and narrative while being seamlessly woven into the emotions that currently resonate with each and every one of us, the audience. Hope, new beginnings and second chances. I'm going to ask Aparna actually to take the first question. Aparna, could I please have you on the screen with me for a quick question that's been really behind me while I was watching the trailer. And my question is, what was the thought behind a concept such as this and using a unique format, you know, for the first Tamil original movie on Prime Video?
I think the thought was very simple, that art can find expression and manifestation in even the most difficult and dreary times. And the fact that art must inspire, provoke and connect people. And we're really fortunate that when we approached these incredible filmmakers with this idea, we got a resounding yes. These filmmakers could make the films in under these stringent restrictions, you know, it just tells us that anybody can. So it's that was the small idea, just to connect people. The fact that Pudam Pudu Kale is our first Tamil anthology is truly serendipity, and I'm really happy that this is ushering in a new dawn for us.
That's so, so wonderfully said, and I just want to say you pulled off a kulu, Aparna, so congratulations and thank you.
I'm knocking on wood.
Knocking on wood, of course, and of course from the fans, sincerely, thank you so much. Up next, could I please request Suhasini ma'am to join me and answer our next question. Ma'am, thank you so much for joining me. From me, from my mother, from my family, just want to say big fan, let me start with that. Thank you so much, Nandri. Yes, thank you. Ma'am, I want to take you back to the idea of, you know, bringing a family together on screen. Did you have the cast in mind while thinking of your story?
First, I have to tell you, I came in last. I think these four people were already on board. And okay. I think one came last to me. And then when they wanted me to do a film, and I had two kinds of stories. And one story was similar to what Karthik Subbaraj was doing. I heard that there were some similarities. So then I thought, what about a short story that I'd written about 10 years ago about two daughters and a son coming back home for their parents' 50th anniversary and the confrontations and the conflicts that they have, because the two daughters have lived abroad all the time, and when they come, they feel even more like, you know, stressed because they're not there for the parents. You know, that was my idea of a short story many years ago, but I hadn't completed the short story. Thanks to Amazon, I completed the story and I changed the son to a daughter to accommodate Shruti. So I wanted to have all the Hasans. I mean, I still consider myself a Hasan, you know, Manidattam, yes, okay. But unfortunately, a week before the shoot, my father met with an accident, and I mean, he fell down and broke his collarbone. So Katadi Ramamurthy came in, otherwise it would have been all Hasan cast. So it has me, Suhasini Hasan, Maniratnam, and then Anu Hasan, Shruti Hasan, and Komalam Charu Hasan, my mother, coming into films after seeing Kamal and myself and you know Mani and my father and Anu Hasan, Shruti Hasan, and you know she's the newcomer into film industry. So it was a casting coup of sorts, but you know it was not difficult because we had these pictures of on the wall for the you know for the set. It was so easy; I could pull it out from the album and you know. I didn't have to, you know, beg my artist, please give me a family photo, give me a childhood photo of yours. I could do that. There were advantages. There were many disadvantages, I guess. I mean, it was fun working with my family, except everybody thought I was, you know, like being very strict with my mother. I have to be strict with my mother. I've been waiting for this for so many years.
Right, absolutely. You know, we've all learned so much about our own families and old relationships in this lockdown. Your film, of course, taking that a notch higher, fictionalizing and giving us this experience. So, Asli ma'am, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you.
Suma ma'am, I'd love you to join me on the screen at this point. Hi and welcome once again.
Hi.
You know, I'm very excited about the fact that this is you and this is also the genre of romance. Let's talk about the idea of you wanting to explore this genre when it came to making this part of this anthology, please.
Okay. So, when Shali and Aparna approached me, it was about hope, new chances, new beginnings, happiness in the times of the pandemic. So, to me, what came instantly was romance. I thought that's the happiest phase of a person's life, apart from them having food, I think. So I said, okay, fine. So if I came up with the story, I was going to do it. If I didn't crack it, I wasn't going to do the film at all. So then this just came in 2 days. It just sat there, and then I told it to Shalini. I told Shalini this, and she was like going crazy with it because she found it so, warm. And then I think it just fell into place. And romance is always fun. I love it.
That's wonderful. We can't wait to watch your interpretation, especially, you know why? Because most of us in this pandemic have also got a chance to revisit what romance is when we don't have any externals, right? And I think that's why I'm really looking forward to your film. Once again, thank you so much for joining me. And as you will, of course, join us in just a little bit, I have Kalidas joining us at this point.
Hi. I just like to say this is a huge fan moment for me because I've been like a huge fan to all those filmmakers who's right here with us. So you know, like it's just a great feeling for me to just be amongst them.
Absolutely, I totally understand it, and we're trying to keep as mature or as responsible a face as we must. But can we, of course. You know, you're a star in your own right. You know, you've been acting since the tender age of 6 and 7. And over the years, we've seen you experiment with different genres and versatile characters. Tell me, is there some sort of a guide where you say, this is the sort of character that I'd like to play? How do you choose that I want to give life to this character?
If I'm being very honest, like, I don't think we can choose because I just do what comes my way. Because there's so many actors and there's so many, you know, very little characters to be played. I think it's already taken. So whatever comes my way, I just do it. And thankfully, I just got a very good, mentor like Sudha ma'am, who gave me this opportunity to work with her. So I'm just happy.
Well, that's wonderful. I was about to ask how that association went, but thank you for answering my question within your first answer. Thank you so much, Kali. We'll be back with you in just a little bit. This is a quick announcement to all the attendees of our conference today. We are open for the media Q&A, and if you'd like, please send us a question in the chat box. But please make sure, since we have so many esteemed voices with us today, kindly direct your question to who you'd like to ask the question to, and of course we will make it a point to ask them your question. Up next, could I please have Gautam Vasudev Menon joining us, please?
Yes, I'm here.
Hi Gautam sir, how are you doing?
I'm good, thank you.
A big fan from Minnale days, so just want to take you back there first of all. And then of course, I'm very curious to know, what is the experience of working on a short, especially when Amazon Prime Video came up to you and said this is going to be a short film format? What changes?
Well, I think I've already been there, so when the call came in, it didn't seem so daunting and challenging. And I think being Reshma and myself, we decided that she'd write and I'd just direct. of course it's not just direct, I mean you still have to, you know, give the script what it actually needs and everything, but she wrote it and it came to me on a platter and I just had to sit in Tamil dialogues and everything. But what seemed daunting and challenging later was to have Rajamannan sir's name, you know, along with mine, my name along with his, and then I worked with him. So right. When I heard that, I told her, I don't think I know, you know, I'll do this, honestly, you know, that's the first thing I said. But she just said, come on, let's just go ahead and do it and all that. So thanks to Amazon for giving me the opportunity to put my name somewhere along with Rajiv sir's name, you know. So it's like, you know, life coming full cycle, so to speak. So I enjoyed the process, and having said that, we went into filming with a master craftsman like PC Sriram sir, and I really looked forward to that. It was a huge learning and humbling experience for me, actually. I've always been wary of working with the greats, and we have two cinematographers on the show here today, Rajiv sir and Suhasini ma'am, and I dare say that I've always been wary of working with the greats, but this was such a huge learning experience for me, and I'd like to thank Amazon again for setting this up, you know, for giving me the opportunity to do that. And in the film there's MS Bhaskar and Ritu, two brilliant actors who sort of, you know, we just had to talk the script to them, and they gave it to me again on a platter. So it was a great experience.
Thank you so much, Gautam, for revealing a few of your own sort of inner workings. So when it comes to being a part of this wonderful production, and since you mentioned Bhaskar sir, I'm going to ask him to take the next question. Thank you so much, Gautam. We'll be with you in just a little bit. Bhaskar sir, namaskaram.
Hey, namaskaram.
You know, before entering the industry, you were always a very renowned theatre artist. I actually want to know, as someone who's watched you, you know, does theatre experience help you in choosing or giving life to a character? And also, what is the one thing that you think you will remember the most from this short film experience?
Yeah. First thing, I was not a theatre artist. I was a dubbing artist.
Yes.
I gave more than 1,500 films yet.
Yes.
Dubbing voice.
Absolutely.
That time, I was very much eager to act in movies and the television serials and very good stories. See, in this Puthumudu Kali, you have to take this thing. All are very good directors, excellent directors, excellent stories in one thing. So, we can call it an assorted sweet box.
Lovely, how lovely.
Because, you know, actual thing, I am a very good foodie, you know. So, only I am talking about sweet, different, everything. So, okay, that's apart. What is the actual thing is, we had to work with this type of excellent directors. Because of that only we can improve our talent more and more. Gautam sir is so nice. PC Sriram sir is so nice. No shouting, nothing, no this thing I want, that thing I want. No embracement to the artist. He gives him freedom to the artist. See, what are you going to do, sir? Let me see once. Like this, he'll ask. And he will extract what he wants at the end.
Wonderful.
Very, very, very comfortable with GVM sir and PC sir and with the whole crew. I was enjoying the shooting like anything. And it's an excellent character acting with Ritu. A bond between the grandpa and the granddaughter. It is excellent. It is an excellent experience, and I want to enjoy the same experience again and again.
Wonderful. Thank you so much. And because you said sweet box, I just want to say this is a free Diwali gift for all of us, you know, who are fans of everybody's work. And I think my little limited Tamil, please don't mind. I would just like to say one thing, sir. Pramadam, sir. Pramadam.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. And since you mentioned Ritu, I'm gonna have the wonderful Ritu Verma join us as well. Hi Ritu, thank you so much for joining us.
Hi, thanks for having us.
you know, I'm so curious to know, you've had such a great stint, you've had award-winning performances, and I'm sure viewers are kind of wanting to know, what is that sneak peek you can give us into your character, you know, in this short? What can you reveal?
I don't know if I can reveal much about my character, but I must say this has been a wonderful experience. I love working with Gautam sir and his team. I would never say no to working with Gautam sir. So when this came my way, it was just too good to say no. Working with BC sir has been like a dream come true. Bhaskar sir is such a brilliant actor, and we share a good bond on and off screen. And it's with Amazon Prime. So it's my digital debut. I'm really looking forward to it.
That's wonderful, and we wish you luck, and I hope that you conquer the digital scape as much as you have the rest. Thank you so much, Ritu, for joining me.
Thank you.
Right, you know, Gautam spoke a little bit about being a fanboy. So Rajiv sir, I think the first thing we have to do is sort of acknowledge that, and then I'll ask you a question. Is that okay?
Oh yeah. Gautam is one of my, I think, really successful and talented guys, great sense of music, great sense of style, and I'm so moved and touched that somebody who worked with me has done so well, but is viewing you with respect and things, so I'm kind of humbled by that. I'm grateful. Yes.
Thank you. Thank you so much for that. You know, I do know that this has been a very unique experience for most filmmakers. How long did it take you to complete the shoot of this film? And was it different in terms of methods, given the restrictions, given the stipulations? What will always be memorable for you?
I think one of the things that I felt is that because there were restrictions on the number of people you can employ, primarily for safety reasons,
right,
it sort of took me back to the time that we used to make films in the Film Institute, you know, I mean, like with a very limited crew.
Correct.
And in this particular case, we were also having, you know, a person in the cast who is not a conventional actor, but is actually acting really for the first time on things. So I wanted to use multiple cameras. So with a very limited crew and three actors, so I'm just left with one lightman, you know, one camera attender. And so it's a really slim production around it. And on top of it, I have a lady who's somebody I really respect a lot, like Leela Samson. And I got to make sure she's safe through the shoot. So there is one element of, my God, nothing should happen to Leela and nobody should get infected during the shoot. So this is really worrying while we're doing. But the moment we had a reading, we found that everybody is really into it, you know, and the performances really started, you know, going up. And since it's a very small unit, it's very intimate. So I kind of really enjoyed the process. But I'm even more curious to see how others have interpreted the same brief, you know. So it's like you know, five different melodies being composed in five different houses, which now are all going to come together, and you know, it's going to reach, like, it's like five different tunes coming together. I kind of really fascinated by that.
What a beautiful example, and absolutely, it's five different melodies coming together and building that symphony, and that's what we're looking forward to. Thank you so much for joining me this afternoon. Up next, of course, could I please request Karthik Subbaraj to join us?
Hi.
Hi, Karthik.
Hi.
I think we've all seen the phenomenal thriller Penguin on Prime Video, and first of all, I want to congratulate you on your release of that, firstly.
Thank you so much.
All right, let's talk about the experience of shooting in an unlocked phase. You know, Rajiv sir talked about how he had to double up. Tell me, how different was it for you as well, you know, from the usual format?
Actually, it was not so different because I came from making short films, right? So I actually felt sort of, because during Nale, you know, time I used to be sort of a competition where I used to make short films, and my co-contestants will be like Nalan and Balaji Bohan, but this time it was Gautam sir, Rajiv Mohan sir, who was in, I sort of felt like going back to the Nala Ekner time. So it's actually very, very kicked about, because Bobby was faster than him, because he used to act in all of his short films. So we actually felt, okay, I think this corona has actually taken back to where we started. So it was actually good.
That's wonderful. Thank you so much. And since you mentioned Bobby, I'm going to have Bobby up next with me. And can I have a request? You know, staying in Mumbai, my Tamil never really reached where it was supposed to reach. But I'm craving to hear a little bit of Tamil today, and I'm going to request Bobby sir, நீங்கள் தமிழ் பேசினால, I will feel very, very happy. Will you please answer my question in Tamil? Is that okay?
Tamil la pesuven.
Thank you so much. So please forgive my terrible Tamil, but I'll ask you the question. I know Miracle, the film, has united you and Karthik after your highly successful film Jigatanda. We also won a national award. Tell me, how is it when this pairing comes together again? Are people expecting the same sort of magic? Is there a pressure?
Look, Kandipa, while we are shooting, நானும் கார்த்திக் அது அப்படியே ஒரு 10 வருஷத்துக்கு முன்னாடி போன மாதிரி இருக்கு. ஏன்னா கம்மியான க்ரூ அந்த ஒரு இன்னொரு சிச்சுவேஷன்ல, ஆனா பட் ரொம்ப நல்லா இருந்தது. ரொம்ப லவ் பண்ணி தான் பண்ணோம் அது பண்ணும்போதெல்லாம். எனக்கும் அது இருந்தது. சூதுக்கவுக்கு அப்புறம் நான் காமெடி பண்ணதில்ல, எனக்கு காமெடி வருமானது ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஆஃப் ஆல் தெரியாது. பட் நலனுக்கு ஸ்ட்ராங்கா சஜஸ்ட் பண்ணது கார்த்திக் தான், அவன் பண்ணுவான் நம்ம அக்ரி பண்ணுங்கன்றது. ஸோ அதுக்கப்புறம் அத இந்த மிரக்கல் பண்ணும்போது அந்த ஃபீல் இருந்தது. பட் அத கார்த்திக் சொன்ன மாதிரி அந்த 10 இயர்ஸ் பேக் போயாது நமக்குள்ள அப்படி ஒரு சின்னதாக இருக்கு, நம்மளே எல்லா வேலையும் பார்த்துட்டு நம்மளே இது பண்ணி அந்த மாதிரி ஒரு ரொம்ப லவ் பண்ணி பண்ணல மிரக்கல் ஆக்சுவலி.
Wonderful, wonderful. It truly is a miracle. Thank you so much, Bobby, for joining me. And thank you so much. I was so happy to hear someone speak in Tamil. Even though the brief for today's chat was in English, I just thought a little bit of Tamil would do justice to this wonderful ensemble of talents from all over. For right now, of course, I want to first thank our talents and our directors who've been with us. I'm going to direct this next segment to our friends from the media. Once again, I'm going to say, if you have questions, Jyoti Venkatesh is here, okay, and this is a message. Jyoti, I want to ask you who you are directing the question to. Jyoti, I want you to tell me who you're directing your question to. Thank you. Okay, here's a question for you, Rajiv. How different was it for you to make a short or an anthology with your expertise as a DOP as well as a filmmaker? Would you please take this question again?
Yeah, I think, I have under the impression that as a cinematographer, I never shot my own film because I thought that it would affect my directorial space. So I would either be a cinematographer or this thing. But there are commercials where, I kind of shoot and direct. But because we had three, artist and we were working in a fairly large space, I had to shoot and direct. And I kind of really enjoyed it because there was a lot of handheld and there was a lot more intimate kind of shooting. And I kind of learned that I can do both during this period. So I it was a learning experience for me and I kind of really enjoyed it.
There's another question for you, Rajiv. I'm going to follow it up right away because it's an interesting one. Because you're also someone who has been a cinematographer, I believe you're someone who's fairly insistent about the way you shoot. So what did you go back to when it comes to making a film through that lens? It's a lovely question.
Yeah, I think one of the things that I've been studying globally about cinematography is that I find there's a kind of change globally. You're seeing a more natural kind of style where you're not really lighting up for the face, but you kind of light it for the general the area or the geography that you're shooting in, and not specifically putting key light. And that sort of worked very well in this case. We were not having lights on the actors, but actually pushing it through windows and stuff like that. So the space we act in is devoid of lights. And that in turn means that there's a lot of movement possible and you can cover two cameras at the same time. And so those are things that I was experimenting. There were times where I was actually doing three cameras. So I think I kind of really enjoyed that.
Yeah, that I think has been the biggest exercise in this lockdown, right? The idea of us being in closed spaces and then telling the stories without the outdoors. How does that change the visual narrative? Well, thank you so much, Rajiv. And if we have a question again for you, I will bother you again. Thank you so much for that. All right, I have understood that Jyoti Venkatesh's question is for Suhasini ma'am at this point. Suhasini ma'am, the question is, what message would you like to drive home to the viewers during the pandemic of maybe through your film?
Hello to Jyoti Venkatesh. It's been a long time, Jyoti, since I've seen you.
and nice to have a question from you. What do I want to tell family? I think it's time that we value the things that we have and not try for something that we don't have. Especially the SPB's death has kind of shaken all of us, and it's time we started recognizing the love and talent that is around us. I think my film is something like that. A family is concentrating on one person who's very special to all of them. And some people in the family have actually had some conflicts and confrontation with that particular relative, and they've kept away from that person. But the family brings all of them together. See, we all grew up in big joint families. I mean, today's children are not, they don't have the luxury of growing up in a large joint family. Somewhere, I think the pandemic kind of put in that joint family, you know, concept again. I think we should spend a lot of time with people we love and say sorry to them and say, I love you, because it might be too late. If you don't say, I love you, and if you don't say, I'm sorry, and if you don't say, like, I really admire you, it might be too late. I think my film is also saying the same thing.
How beautiful. Almost teared up there, but thank you so much, because yes, what you're talking about is such a universal truth. Do we really spend time speaking to the ones that we love and telling them that we love them? Thank you for that. Beautiful question, Jyoti. Thank you so much again. At this point, I want to bring Aparna in. Aparna, I think this is a great question. I'm going to take it to you. The question is, how did the anthology get to be named Puttam Pudukkam?
Yeah, we toyed with many ideas, but I think it means Puthupudam Khare is such a beautiful, it has such a beautiful meaning, a new dawn, and I think it beautifully encapsulated the overarching thread of all the films.
Wonderful.
But we had to take a lot of input from all our creators.
Oh, okay, so was it a vote? I'm really curious to know, did you send them like options on WhatsApp? First of all, is there a WhatsApp group with these five amazing creators or no?
We send them so many mails, they don't want to be on another WhatsApp group with us. We barrage them with our mails and messages individually. But we got inputs from everyone. We also sought our marketing team's advice, and it just had such a beautiful ring to it. So yeah, we decided to go ahead with it.
Thank you so much. That is the answer to the question. It's a fantastic question, by the way. Up next, I'm going to take this to Gautam Vasudev Menon. Interesting. What was the liberty that you took as a filmmaker while you work, you know, in an anthology format? I'm not so sure what the question means, but I'd like to think you can make a little bit of sense of it. Is there a liberty as a filmmaker that you've taken while making the short?
Well, I think these ideas and scripts will not get to be in a feature film in the first place. So that's correct. Limitation by itself, you know, and your whole short division and everything. You're actually filming for the content and not worrying about the magic or the mood of the theater, and will the audience be affected 10 minutes into the screenplay? Should a particular lengthy shot be there? You're not thinking of all that. So I think what the question is trying to find out is what I'm thinking. I think it's very liberating in that sense itself, from the concept to the length to the way you film itself. Like I said, how can you convince a producer about a story between a grandfather and a granddaughter? It's done 25 years ago, but it's not going to be so easy now. They're going to be asking you who's the hero and what the business is like and stuff like that. So I think that's what this means, yeah.
You know, it's a beautiful interpretation, and that's why you are who you are, GVM. You took the word liberty and made it about how it's liberated you as a narrator or a teller of stories. So thank you for that. So now the next question is for you, if I might please have you with me on the screen. Very interestingly, the question is about your casting. So you took Kalidas and Jairam sir back to the screen after 20 years. How do you go behind actors to find your characters? And this is by Rajivan Francis from India Glitz.
So I think you should actually ask me this question after watching the film. The film is, it just had to be them. It just had to be like, I would be giving you spoilers if I told you why I had to choose them. But the thing is, Kalidas and Jairam sir were fixed in my head. For Urvashi ma'am, I had to find somebody who was like Urvashi ma'am. And for that, that was a difficult search. And then she suggested Kalyani. And I went back and I looked at some of Kalyani's performances, and she was terrific. And once you watch the film, you'll understand why I had to choose these four, especially Jairam sir and his son.
That's wonderful.
And
that's
I've worked with Kali before, and I think he's one of the most amazing underutilized talents we have right now, and he's just performed brilliantly. And in two films that I've worked with him in, they're like absolutely poles apart. One is the other end of the spectrum, which is a very, very sad and very moody kind of a film. And this one is a very happy, romantic film, and he aced both.
Thank you so much for that answer. My next question is actually going to be to Kali. And I'm going to follow the same question up to Ritu as well, right after. The question is actors, you know, you're clearly... there's a lot riding on you and there's a lot of pressure because you've got to be in fever form. Your throat can be bad. You can have a fever. You've got to look a certain way. You know, and when you think of the pandemic, it's obvious that you have to put yourself first. But when the shot starts, you know, do you forget everything and just, you know, focus on that shot itself? I want to know the inner workings of how does an actor deal with a pandemic which is so prevalent or no?
When we shot this movie, we already had gone through 4 months of lockdown. So I was just waiting to go back to work. I didn't care about the pandemic or anything. I just wanted to work. So maybe I was just happy to be there in the set. But just that I spent 4 months at home seeing my father's face. And then I go back to work expecting to see someone else. And then I see his face. So that is not fun.
Thank you so much for joining us once again on the Q&A. I'm going to take the same question to Ritu. Ritu, could you please tell me what your thoughts are? Were you the same? Were you also excited just to be back on a set?
I'll be very honest. Initially, I was a little apprehensive because I had to travel from Hyderabad to Chennai to shoot for the film. But I think it's the love for cinema that I had that couldn't stop me. So I just had to do it. And yes, I mean, during this pandemic, I think there's a lot going on in everybody's head, not just actors, but also other technicians in everybody else. But yeah, as I said, it's the love for cinema that, you know, that's not letting us stop from getting back to work.
Thank you so much. The love of cinema just wants everybody to get back to work. I'd like to take the next question to Bhaskar, sir. The question is from Manoj from Indian Express. His question is, what are the great joys and challenges when you're working on a short film? How does the format change?
See, there's no big difference between short film or big screen.
Mm-hmm.
Because acting is same. For the character, what are all the things we have to do? We must do if it is big or small. Okay, so we have to enjoy the character first and we have to express our feelings. So I don't find any big difference between big screen and small screens.
Thank you so much. How beautifully said. Because if you're an actor, a screen should not matter, of course. I'm going to take the next question to Karthik. Karthik, you talked about being nostalgic, you know, because it is a short film format. And this is a question that has come in as well, which is, did you feel nostalgic exploring the platform of telling a story in a shorter format yet another time? What was something that you really enjoyed telling stories in this shorter time?
Yeah, I mean, actually, I enjoyed a lot because when they actually said that we need to make an anthology film with the concept of whatever, the new beginning. So I actually got into it because as Gautam sir said, we can't make all the thing that inspires you into a feature film. So this particular film is actually inspired from a real life theft that happened in Bobby's office. So
Okay.
So that happened. So actually that happened during the lockdown time. So during lockdown time, in Bobby Simha's office, there was a test happening. So I was actually casually talking to him, like, okay, we should make this as a short film sometime. But then an ideal chance came. So I wrote this film. So I actually enjoyed making a small idea into a 20-minute film. So it actually processes. Yeah.
I've got to love filmmakers because filmmakers take someone's pain and make it into a film and everyone's loving it, you know. But that's not Bobby at this point, because he lost something.
And the good thing is I made Bobby as a thief also.
thank you Karthik for that. I'm going to get Bobby in. Bobby, what have you lost? What do people come and steal from your house or your office? Please tell us this story. Yeah.
Kati, so actually I'm producing a film, not it revealed actually. So suddenly this quarantine time, I was staying in a Kodaikanal with my family.
Mm-hmm.
So suddenly I got 2 months over, okay, right, let's go. And something happened in the sleep, I like, okay, I have to move Chennai because there's a problem for e-pass and everything. Something is wrong, I have to go to Chennai back. And my wife and my father, mother are shouting, what the hell, why? Suddenly after somewhere, I got the e-pass and I started. The midnight and I came and I started that morning 4 a.m. and suddenly went to I saw an office. So the door was opened. I called my friends, I called Satish. Hey, office totally, then everything, the costume boxes, everything was broken and thrown out. I'm going watching and edit system totally. All of it 3 times.
Ayo.
Costumes for everything.
Ayo. Everybody just wants to know the end of the real story, not of the anthology, but in your real life, did you find the thief?
Yes, actually, I wrote my poor and sutra. All of me Sunday, when all the people chulla putta, all of them give a okay down and sorted. All of them say, "No, different stories are happening to them." Actually, police came. Pudu kada all karche the. Didn't 4 minute yedigra varan the teru kula light headlight off when he is coming. In my sleep, I remember the headlight off. Then now, I put a very interesting story.
You know, Bobby, as you tell me this story, there is, of course, the sort of laughter that, you know, because it's a great story and, of course, it makes a wonderful story. But at the same time, it also gives me a glimpse into what a hard time the pandemic was for people. You know, I know for a fact that even in Mumbai, I've heard of stories where people who were caught being thieves were not thieves in the first place. They just had a tough time in the pandemic. And I think this is a great time to, you know, go into a sort of message or something that you've learned. And I'm going to take this to everybody around. I'm going to start with you, Bobby, because we were talking to you only. What is the one message that you have probably learned or you've realized or you want to give your audience as we end this press conference today? What would you like to tell them? I hope I'll be able to translate it correctly. Message on the audience ke in the pandemic learning gal enna enna message kuduka poringa
na indha sense jara solla na ellana safe a irunga idha solla mudiyum to be frank but anna vandu இந்த சிச்சுவேஷன் என்ன கொண்டு வந்துச்சு அப்படின்னா எல்லாத்துக்குமே வந்து ஒரு வீட்டுக்குள்ள ஒரு பாண்டிங் கொண்டு வந்திருக்கு, ஒரு ஃபேமிலியோட ஒரு டைம் ஸ்பெண்ட் பண்றதுக்கு கொண்டு வந்திருக்கு. ரியலி வந்து கரோனா பேடா குட்டா அப்படின்னு கேட்டா பேட் பேட் இருக்கு, குட் குட் இருக்கு. பட் ஆனா வந்து ஒரு மூமெண்ட் ஒன்று கொடுத்துச்சு, ஒரு பாண்டிங், ஒரு ஃபேமிலிக்குள்ள ஒரு பாண்டிங் ஆகட்டும், உங்களோட டைம் ஸ்பெண்ட் விஷயம் ஆகட்டும், அந்த வேல்யூஸ் தெரிஞ்சுக்கிற விஷயம் ஆகட்டும், எல்லாமே ஐ திங்க் எல்லாருமே அது புரிஞ்சிருக்கும் நினைக்கிறேன். பட் நான் அனலைஸ் பண்றது அந்த ஒரு விஷயம் தான்.
Correct. Absolutely. Absolutely. I also got that message from Suhasini, ma'am, so I'm not going to repeat it. But Bhaskar sir, I think it would be lovely as you to close this today for us and tell people what is that one message that everybody should keep in mind.
Empowerment.
Yes. What have you learned from the pandemic?
Yeah, yeah.
What have you realized?
Yeah. See, we have forgotten our tradition. Cleanliness and everything and antibiotics, we are moving on to allopathy. We have forgotten totally about the Siddha and Ayurveda everything. That is again coming because of this corona. So we are all having, as Bobby said, we are all having a bonding with our family. But actually what is the thing is, we have to be inside the home safely. I have to say it in Tamil, it will be very beautiful. Corona vanaala bayam mattum vandal veetukulliye irukalam ana pasiye sende varudha evlo nalaki veetukulliye irukum. We are feeling hungry, we have to feed everybody at home, we have to move out, but we have to be careful like our and ancestors. They are saying namaskaram.
Absolutely.
And they are not shaking hand with others. My father won't shake hand with others. He used to say namaskaram. So we are going to the olden and golden days because of this corona.
And that's why I think I chose him to give us the message to wrap today's event. I just want to say, so beautifully said, Bhaskar sir, thank you so much. Just want to say, as somebody who grew up in Mumbai, quite divorced from the beautiful content that comes from the South, I want to thank Amazon Prime Video for making that bridge. You know, at one point, my mother used to always say, Vadi, Aurora Cinema, you know, we got to go watch a film there. And you know, sometimes we'd go, sometimes we'd not go, but she doesn't have to do that anymore to me, because I can just get all of the best content that there is across the country thanks to Amazon Prime Video. So thank you so much, Aparna, once again for having this commitment to put out this content. I once again want to remind all of our wonderful audience members to catch Puttam Pudukale exclusively on Amazon Prime on the 16th of October. And of course, for our friends from the press, there is a press kit in the link provided to you. Please do remember to collect that. As somebody who never thought she'd have the opportunity to have so many greats in one frame, thank you so much, and hopefully my Tamil will be better next time. Please forgive me in case there was any mistake.
Thank you
very much. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you.